So this approach was majorly influenced by the rising of academic scholars such as Oprah in 1972 and Rubin in 1975. So gender involvement is an approach of the ideology which was done by these two scholars, Oprah in 1972 and Rubin in 1975. Who argued the social relationship between men and women? Systematically supporting women and women's economic scholars. So, they say these two, they argue the social relationship between males and women. They are trying to argue the roles that have been placed in our society in regarding to the third man, So, the other gender scholars, along with by the economists, who also came in and agreed with the two scholars in 1981, who assessed the impact of colonialism on development and gender inequality. So, as these two academicians were arguing, the Rubin and Oprah were asking about the relationship that this gender role comes into society. In fact, my economists now also they came in and they were saying, they were assessing the impact of colonialism. What is colonialism?
When white people want to be part of some African country, they don't know what house they come out of.
So that this economist was assessing the impact of that colonialism on the African countries. Like, the fact that they came in and colonized these African countries, the colonialism also had impact in gender and government. They also had an influence on how gender and government has been perceived. They state that colonialism imposed more than a value system upon developing nations. It introduced a system of economics designed to promote capital accumulation, which caused class differentiation. So they are saying that colonialism, one of its impacts, it brought class. Do you understand when they say different classes in society? Can you mention the classes that are found in
society?
So colonialism also had an impact in bringing class in society. So they say gender involvement departs from women in development. Gender involvement women involvement there. It's like what this is women involvement, gender involvement, women involvement, it departs from women and women, which discusses women's subordination and lack of inclusion in discussions of international development without examining broader system of gender relations. So, women's involvement, as I said, put many focuses on women, it only talks about women's involvement. While gender involvement, it talks about all genders being actually involved towards development. So, influenced by this place by the late, in the 1970s, some practitioners working in the development field questioned focusing on women's isolation. So, gender involvement challenged the women's development focus on women as an important target group and take resource for development. So, the gender involvement approach was there to criticize the women's involvement, because the women's involvement are merely looking only women, leaving out the other gender. So, the gender involvement approach is there to include an inclusion of all genders towards development. So gender is both much a shift in thinking about the need to understand how women and men are socially constructed and how those constructions are powerfully reinforced by the social activities that both define and redefine and are defined by them. So gender involvement came in to redefine what was already defined by the women in involvement. Gender involvement focuses primarily on the gender divisions of labor and gender and the relation of power in the institution. So gender involvement also looks at, apart from the labor, it also looks at the power that they should be. So you can say gender involvement looks at equity and equality between the two genders. While women involvement solely focuses on the women. So the two major frameworks, gender roles, social relations, and so the gender involvement focuses mainly on the gender roles and then social relations analysis. How these are used, the gender roles focuses on the social and construction of identities within the household. It also reviews the expectations of maleness and femaleness. So it also looks at the expectations, as we have talked about the roles, which is that the male roles and the female roles. But gender involvement, it critically looks at into these roles, which is these roles, they should not be in it, they should not be differentiation. What a man can do, women can do, but it is better. Even when it comes to power, if you have a manager who is a man, even women can also become managers, as long as they have the right credentials to put them in that particular position. All this done for the development of the nation. It doesn't matter whether to fight only women, it should also be in the top position. No? This one they say we should not only look at the women, but we should not only put women in position, but they have the right qualification for them to be put in those positions. Yes, all of them, they have. A woman has a degree, a man has a degree, all of them they are fighting for a managerial position. That means all of them they qualify. Now, if all of them they qualify, they should be picked based on merit. So, social relations, the social relations analysis exposes the social dimensions of hierarchy power relations embedded in social institutions. I'm very good about that. As well as determining influence on the relative position of men and women in society. This relative position tends to discriminate against women. I've already talked about this issue. We are looking at the power sharing in the institution. We should not regard everybody just because it's a woman. But we can see what in our society. Between women in development and gender and women, which one is being more relevant in our society? Women in development and gender and women, which one is more relevant? Women in development, everything is related to women. Yeah. To the extent that, for example, when you go on social media, it's only about women, and men are being very angry regarding the comment. What do you want to do? Why are you going to so that means we are very stuck in women and development rather than us being stuck in gender and development. So unlike women and women in development, the gender and development approach is not concerned specifically with women. That is one of us. Unlike women in development, the gender and development approach is not concerned specifically with women. For it, it concerns both men and women. But the way in which a society assigns roles, this responsibility and expectations to both men and women. So it's not, for it, it's not specifically about women. For my gender and government is concerned about it, assigned roles, responsibilities, and expectations of both men and women. While women in government, for them, they are solely concerned about women. But gender and government looks at both men and women. You know, the global gender and government should be able to differentiate women in government, women and women. and gender and grouping. You should be able to know it, critique it. That's why I let our good government message for you to have an in-depth understanding. Then I know you did it, you take time, you said you know who knows, but we're going to do it, and we're going to do it.
Okay.
because of the reasons why they don't do themselves. So, in response to preventing gender inequality and the Beijing platform of action, established gender mainstreaming in 1995 as a strategy across all policy areas at all levels of governance for achieving gender equality. So, gender mainstreaming when you look at kind of formulation of a policy. So, the Beijing platform of action in 1995 came up, established gender mainstreaming, that's in 1995, to talk about this type of policies, which in our places, if all are holding the same position regardless of their gender, they should be aiming the same pay. Commercially, they are okay. If in which places, they should come up with a policy that favor both gender equally. So, gender and the development has been largely applied to debate regarding development, but this trend is not seen in the actual practice of development agencies and plan of development. Now, with gender and development, we talk a lot. Like people talk about it, when it's like theoretically being taught, more practically, it's not being practiced.
Yeah.
You know, theoretically, we are talking about gender and development. Or I need to know about the gender development, because I'm not looking at the other government and development.
Yes, why not?
Gender planning development world was working with the University of London. When he was hiring Ramsey, she expanded it into a methodology for gender policy and planning. You see? Because she said it's very hard for gender and women to practical. The challenge came in because the policies favor women and women. So this lady also took part in gender mainstream in coming up with the policies that favor gender and women. The Monster framework follows the gender and women approach in emphasizing the importance of gender relations. As with women and women, they have an analytical framework. So the way the women and women have an analytical framework, while the gender and women have the Monster planning, Monster gender and planning framework. So the gender development has the Monster gender planning framework, while the women development has the Harvard analytical framework. These are two different policy frameworks. So she should be able to know what is the Monster gender planning framework was done by who? It was done by Caroline, who was working at the University of London. What about the Harvard analytical routine? What does it talk about? Talks about women in development. Man, go on, go on, go
on, go on.
That it is the intent of the gender role that doesn't work on it. Gender practice doesn't change on changing the gender roles that we have already talked about. This gender role can be effective if this gender roles they are being talked about in such a way that there should be no gender roles. Everyone should be able to do anything. If it's driving, women should also be able to drive. If it's cleaning the house, men should also be able to clean the house. They should just be roles.
Yeah.
And they should be shared equally. So that's one of the challenges that gender development has faced. Another criticism is that gender and development does not dig deeply enough into social relations, and so may not explain how these relations can demand programs directed at women. It also does not uncover the type of trade-offs that women are prepared to make for the sake of achieving the ideals of marriage and motherhood. So the thing with gender and women, it does not uncover if women, they also want to be active, they want also to actively participate in development. What effect do it have on their marriage and motherhood? From your experience, if you have come across, or maybe in your homes, or maybe in your homes, your mother and your father, all of them, they are working, but your mother is actively working, your father is also actively working. Does this have an impact in their marriage at your home? Do you see any impact?
No.
There's a difference?
Yeah.
What are the differences?
Lack of communication.
Lack of communication?
Yeah, so they have to resist the proper
communication.
No one has been able to communicate.
So you go back to school?
No.
Okay.
It's a matter of fact, like, they're not working. The children, if they interact with the children, there will be lack of communication with the children. They have to spend with the children so that they are not even.
You have a point when you explain yourself.
Yeah.
I think, let me help you a bit. You're trying to say, since all of them are working, you mentioned the point about relationships. So, if the parents are always working, they don't have time to talk with their children. Like, they don't know a lot, like, what's happening with their children, how they are surviving, how they are doing their things home, or what are they doing at school. They don't go through their stuff because they are always tired. Maybe they are always busy with weight rather than their kids, who sometimes are going through also problems like peer pressure,
bad company.
Yeah.
So it's like gender development has said that women need, it does not uncover the type of trade-offs. The trade-off is like when women are also actively involved in the development, but what trade-offs do you? What impact does it have in their marriages or motherhood? It's like they spend most of their time at work, because back then women were recognized as caregivers. They were recognized as caretakers, and the ones who were 100% responsible for the children's welfare. If anything to do with the children, the women were in the forefront knowing all whatever is happening to their children, while the man was there all out going to look for money for the house. So nowadays, women are also out looking for money for the house. So that means that in terms of marriage being neglected, parents have no time for their children, the children lack parental care. Children lack parental care. Parents are always looking, hunting for money, standing to stand, hunting for money. So they follow, you have a lot of money, you have all the resources, but you lack parental care. You don't have someone to talk to heart to heart. You don't need someone if anything will happen, someone, the parents have no time for you to explain if you have a school president, and you just join those bad companies. You don't need to have anyone. Kuhu, you don't need to join our dollar visa for me, man. Since I do this, for you, you have all the resources, but you lack parental care. So that's one of the criticisms that Jesus is going to bring about, which is also the result and cover the death of trade-offs. Trade-offs that women are prepared to make, because women who are actually involved in development, there are some sacrifices that they make. But we can otherwise,
yeah.
if you're in a working class woman, you go to work after then you come back in the evening, definitely, because you have kids, that means you're supposed to have someone to help you at home. Nanny, one kid, then. So one kid, then I'm going to have to ask you, my daddy, is the one who comes. She's the one responsible for cleaning the house, taking care of the kids, you've got to end up school.
Second wife.
Oh.
Yeah, second wife.
Those are some of the trade-offs. So those are some of the criticisms that the trade-offs that women are prepared to make for the sake of. So in New York, women, if you are prepared, you are being prepared, if you are going to be a working class, you should be very open. How are you going to cover these issues about marriage if you aspire to get married? How are you going to balance? Because there should be a balance between marriage and your wage. If you don't balance that two things, one thing suffers. If it's not your wife suffering, then it's your house suffering. Yes? Because another, you're able to you have money, you're able to provide for the family. From another, you're able to understand what I'm going to soak. That means one thing is suffering. You might be taking care, very good care of your family, but then you will treat one well, about another, because you're not always on time, you're not always keeping up with the marital center, because you are putting too much attention to your family. So you need to balance these two up. So as a woman, should be very convincing, but human, how are you going to balance your money? You aspire to get married, or how are you going to balance up with your weight? Maybe there are for me, marriage is not my thing, which is going to be a working class woman. It's up to you as a woman. So that's one of the things that you need to get prepared in how you're going to choose them.
Before you marry this guy so that you don't have to go to the and you'll be taking care of his kids. If I start waiting, I'm done. I'll be waiting, Come back tomorrow. That's
just the meaning of the world. So, another criticism is that gender and women's perspective is theoretically distinct from women in development. But in practice, program seems to have elements of both. So, another criticism of gender and women is that practically, theoretically, very good the gender and women approach. Theoretically, it's very good. Come on the ground. It's not that distinct. It's mixed up with women in development. So while many development agencies are now committed to gender approach in practice, the primary institutional perspective remains focused on women in development approach. So it's a good, yes, we're talking about gender development, but we have a ground to go to gender women in development. Probably girls. All of them. So, specifically, the language of gender and government has been incorporated to women in development programs. I would say, despite all these gender and government approaches have been incorporated to women in development, now, the challenge is because we're talking about gender and development, we're talking about feminism, while the feminist movement is for them mainly. Remember, we're talking about the different types of feminism, but there are the level of the feminist movement for which, for them, the solarized movement is involved, the reprobat. For them, they are very focused on women. But there's also another group of feminism for them, they are able to cooperate with men. So it depends. So if we have a lot of movements which are reprobat, they're only fighting for women, it's very hard for the gender movement approach to be practical. So it's like, okay, my approach is, I will be as far as I am, I will give my ground. And then you find it more most organizations, you find most there are people in the women involvement approach. Because when I look at the community movement or the women involvement approach, they are not local, families are taught in there. So in your body, big students who have done gender involvement should be very cognizant of women involvement, women and development, gender and involvement. So then you can also go along with implementing women and development. Can you not tell me this guy? Then what kind of a goal of a feminist and plurality of a feminist?
I don't
know if you have a lot of money. So, development agencies still advance gender transformation means economic betterment for women. So that the system of gender development is insufficient attention to Gaza, with a new framework being offered instead, women, Gaza, and women. So, there are also another project that are saying women, Gaza, and women. This framework, unlike gender development, couldn't look at women as victims, but rather evaluate the same world life of women through the context of language and practice of gender and global style and character. So there are a lot of approaches coming in. But as of now, we are supposed to be very committed to see development, women and development, gender and development. So that means Abaco de Cagero will finalize this to name the book, women in. Any questions, any comments?
So, there's no a public men in development.
There's no, because the approach which came in the women is women is being criticized. That's why we're talking about gender and women. Gender and women looks about both of gender.
Women, men in development is okay in another way.
Thank you. So many people explain the relationship that exists between that is between the male and female. Commercial, we talked about the trade-offs that women make as they are also actively being involved in gender involvement. And we talked a lot about marriage and motherhood. Then we talked about that gender involvement is very beautiful theoretically, gender involvement is very beautiful, but practically it's a mix up of women involvement and gender involvement. So practically it's very hard, and we think it's being hard because of the policies that are there. They are policies are made in the form of gender women involvement. That's why the most gender planning and involvement framework, which also is designed to come up with policies that favor gender and development. So it's about policy. It's about gender mainstreaming. Policies, they are the ones which have a very big impact on whatever is happening on the ground. So if you have policies that are favored women in development, gender development going to be practiced on the ground is a challenge. So my point is, you don't know what I mean. I thought you told me this the gender involvement, are you guys taking advice with this? No.
No.
But you have a question to talk about my policy, yes?
Yes.
Gender involvement, what's really the issue of gender identity as one thing? Because you also do one of the people making my policy. So if you don't know, could you put him in a proverbial policy? What are the stages? Similar, right? Because gender involvement, you know that you are able to see the relationship, right? Between this point, this one, you're saying gender involvement, eh? For now, I'm telling you, could you end up with that? Because if you post in a one term, then I'm reflecting and show someone. We saw post in a question about advocate. That's why you want to be a very good advocate. You should be able to know this. As you are advocating, your advocate should end up at you making a policy. So you guys, gender involvement, you're the one who is responsible to come up with a policy. You should be able to know this for me to come up with a policy. But you may not be able to follow my stage like I have seen. So you should also have the other characteristics of being a very good advocate. Especially if you want to know Any question, any comment? So, next week, what we need, we are going to do a gender mix training.
What is the formulation?
Bye, bye.